Hey guys, welcome back to today's video. There's a question for you. How much power is enough for you to charge all of your devices? Perhaps more than 100 watts? We found that more chargers and power banks can support 100 watts or even more nowadays. So, have you ever thought about combining them into one? Recently, Tegic has launched a Kickstarter campaign for this multifunctional power station, consisting of three parts, a charging station, charging dock, and a power bank. It continues Tegic design style. The cement color shells can be perfectly matched with fluorescent yellow stripes. Three parts can be separated, and you can choose to buy the charging station separately. The power cable and a USB-A port are on the back, since it's still in development, so the final version may vary. ChargerLAB got this power station in advance. Let's try to test it. Firstly, let's try to charge the 8000 mAh power bank separately. And we can see the charging power can be up to 160 to 170 watts. And then let's see how long it'll take to charge the power bank fully. Press the button and switch to 150 watts. Let's start. It only takes about 12 minutes to fully charge the 8000 mAh power bank. That's pretty amazing. So how does it do it? We have to open it and find out the answer. It looks like lithium batteries, but actually it's something called supercapacitor, which is similar to the technology on many electric buses. They are not superior in terms of power density and cost, but they have super fast charging speed. So it can sustain 10,000 charging cycles before reducing to 80%. Back to the charging station. We can see a 1.3 inches OLED display that provides all the charging and system information you need to know. You can also switch it between three different charging modes and it'll display the real-time power of different ports. Let's introduce them one by one. This is the first and default mode. USB A1 and A2 can support 30 watts and 10 watts. USB C1 and C2 can support 100 watts and 65 watts. And this is mode B, which is suitable to fast charge two high-powered devices. The USB A1 will stop working, while USB A2 can only support 10 watts. But both USB C ports can support 100 watts. The mode C can provide stable power output for each port and lower audible noise. USB A1 and A2 can support 30 watts and 10 watts. USB C1 and C2 can support 65 watts and 45 watts. You can long press the upper left button to switch different modes. We've made a chart for you. We can find the supported protocol won't be affected by switching the modes, but the supported PDOs and PBS will vary. After introducing the charging station, let's move to the power bank and the charging dock. The power bank is equipped with a USB-A and a USB-C port with a capacity of 8000 mAh. The 150W charging socket is under the green power button, and the charging indicator is on the front. Flip to the back, we can see the cooling fan that will quickly and continuously dissipate heat. When the power bank is not needed, you can easily separate those two parts to save space of your desktop. Well, that's the brief introduction to this Tegic power station. If you always find your phone dead when you go out or have lots of devices that need to be charged, this product might be your choice. Since it's still in development, some details may vary. If you're interested in this product, feel free to back their project. I'll put the link in the description. Please drop a like, leave a comment, and subscribe to us. Your comments might help this product get better. See you in the next video. Bye!